Good evening, everyone, and welcome. Please join us for the Pledge of Allegiance, led by our Student Council President, Jay Post.
Please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Please be seated. Thank you, Jay, for doing a fantastic job this year of leading our student council. You did a wonderful job, Jay. This year, our eighth grade valedictorian is Emily Burko. And as we begin the 79th graduation exercises of Deerfield School in Mountainside, it is my pleasure to invite Emily to give our welcome address. Emily.
Good evening, Dr. Lubarsky, Mrs. Richards, Ms. Blum, members of the Board of Education, faculty, family, and friends. My name is Emily Burko, and as the valedictorian of this graduating class, it is my pleasure to welcome you all to the Class of 2016 Deerfield Middle School graduation ceremony. Tonight, our journey at Deerfield ends, and we embark upon the new adventures that come with growing up. Next to me, I see classmates with nervous and excited faces who can't wait to conquer whatever life throws their way. In front of me, I see educators and family who are the reason that we can stand here ready to move forward with such confidence. So on behalf of the entire class of 2016, I would like to thank everyone here for helping us become who we are today and for always continuing to help us move forward towards tomorrow. Right now, we're all thinking about what the future holds, but it is equally as important to look back at the past and reflect on how we made it here, in this room, at graduation, finally. Let's look back to 7 years ago, when many of us met for the first time in our kindergarten classrooms. We were scared, worried, and apprehensive of the idea of coming to this big building known as Beechwood every day. Quickly, these fears were left behind as valuable friendships began to form and fun new concepts were introduced to our growing minds. We came home from school every day, not being able to wait to tell our families everything that had happened. The Beechwood years went by in a blur, and all too soon, it was time to move on to the next chapter, the bigger school with the even bigger kids, Deerfield. During the Deerfield years, we gained more maturity and friendships as people continued to join us, and we slowly evolved into the graduating class of 2016 that we are today. Academics became more rigorous, and we enthusiastically accepted the challenges that were thrown at us. Third and fourth grade allowed us to grow comfortable at Deerfield, and it honestly wasn't until I was a fifth grader that I began to realize that someday Deerfield would no longer be the place I pridefully called my school. Sixth grade came and went, and all of a sudden, we were going to be graduating next year. Teachers and parents have told us it's coming up and it'll be here before you know it, and now it is. Tonight we leave the haven that Deerfield has become and enter unknown territory. Next year, and in only a few weeks, is finally right now. While we may be leaving Deerfield, we won't be leaving the memories we've made here behind. They have shaped us into the able young adults we are now and will remain with us for the entirety of our lives. One project we enjoyed this year was working with the kindergartners to make one-of-a-kind bears for Teddy Bear Day, a project that many of us remember doing ourselves 9 years ago. I leave with the satisfying feeling that the event finally came full circle. For years, we've listened with envy to the eighth graders brag about all the trips they get to go on, and now we are, but not for much longer, those eighth graders. These activities included the Broadway trip, where we saw the musical Matilda and took part in a theater workshop, our lunch at the Spanish Tavern, the pool party, the Washington, D.C. trip, the physics bowling trip, the dance, and the breakfast we will enjoy tomorrow. All of these trips turned out to be even more special than we thought they would be, despite the odd theme of rain and umbrellas. Thank you to all of the volunteers who made these events so memorable. When I look around me, I see a class of individuals who have all gained from the support system Deerfield has provided. Despite our differences, I truly feel we will forever have special ties to one another because of our many years spent together here at Deerfield. As we continue to grow, more opportunities will become available to us and will be granted a greater number of freedoms and responsibilities. This graduation ceremony marks the beginning of this chapter in our lives, and hopefully we will never forget how we made it here. One last time, and by the end of the night, I'm sure you'll be tired of hearing it, congratulations and good luck to the class of 2016.
Thank you, Emily. The eighth grade chorus and the eighth grade class of 2016 have chosen three songs to sing for you that celebrate their meaningful friendships that they've made throughout the 9 years in Beechwood and Deerfield schools. With the assistance of our choral director, Mr. Rosenblum, our graduates will present their three class songs, When I Grow Up, Finale B, and I Lived. Mr. Rosenblum.
Thank you guys very much. What a pleasure it has been to teach these amazing, 25 amazing kids all year. They come to my heart every day, they open their mouths and sing. As you guys know and just heard, we saw Matilda as our Broadway show, and the first song that we're gonna sing for you is called When I Grow Up from Matilda. Thank you.
I think the ending is fixed already. I might as well be saying, I think that it's okay. And that's not right.
Stand and you'll be delighted by their beautiful voices as well.
Thank you, class, for sharing those songs. Now it's my turn as the principal to give you a few words before I let you go. This evening, I'd like to say good evening to our graduates, our family members, our Board of Education members, Dr. Lubarsky, and invited guests. I welcome you to this evening's celebration, and I am pleased to stand here with this class of students as they complete their studies here at Deerfield. Graduates, it's truly been my pleasure to be your principal. Your teachers, parents, and I are all very proud of you. I've known you since you were in the third grade, and I can't believe that you're walking across the stage in a few minutes and then on to high school. Knowing you, I'm confident that you'll be very successful as you jump into your next set of studies. Many of you have been counting the days in anticipation of newfound freedoms, opportunities, and responsibilities. Well, this year, I'm thinking back to the Smithsonian National Museum of Natural History, which was one of our choices to tour on our annual trek to Washington, D.C. Now, most years I chaperone a guide group, and they mostly want to see NASA and the space rockets and the like. But this year, my group of eighth grade girls were all about seeing the oceans exhibit and the gem and mineral collection at the Museum of Natural History, especially since this collection displays the famous Hope Diamond. We oohed and awed our way through the exhibit, seeing one spectacular display after another. We saw emeralds and topaz, moonstone, jade, pearls, and rubies. We were amazed at the Bismarck sapphire necklace, the blue spider web opal, the Burmese ruby bracelet, and my favorite, the Tiffany diamond bracelet. Wanted to try it on, they wouldn't let me, but it was delightful to be there and see these jewels. It is funny how that picture of the priceless jewels came back to mind this past Friday night at Deerfield School, or shall I say, Deerfield Radio City Hall entrance, when I was once again with all of you, anxiously awaiting your moment to shine at the long-awaited dance. You were all sparkling and beautiful, just as you are now. Class, your last year is completed, and I see that you are going to be Mountainside's rubies, pearls, and diamonds when you reach your full potential. I want to take a moment to remind you of a few things about gemstones before you move on from Mountainside School District. First off, gems don't start out with their brilliant luster. They're most often found buried in the mines, and when they're discovered, the stones are put in the gem tumbler, and you can hear them rattling around as their true shape and color become apparent. The good news is that right now, you gems are starting to shine. Your teachers and coaches and parents are beginning to see your God-given skills emerge. In fact, I'm tempted to list all the talent that I've seen since we came into Deerfield together, but we would be here much too long. The bad news is, you are just hitting the tumbler. In the coming years, you must choose to persevere through some bumps and bruises, like when you aren't in the starting lineup, when you miss the grade by a few points, when you don't get elected the first time. These are the experiences that will shape you, but they'll help you grow. I recently saw a report on TV about a local high school student, Sydney McLaughlin, who is competing for a place in the Olympic team in Rio this summer. As I watched in awe as Sydney sprinted around the track and leapt over hurdles, I was surprised to read the large block print on her shirt. It said, "I hate running." What a great reminder that was about the need for perseverance. Secondly, gems, especially diamonds, are known for their facets. And you too have many facets. You have unique qualities. I urge you to explore your interests, things that you enjoy, and then dig in deeper than most people do. Be fully engaged in meaningful activities and pursuits. Believe that you will someday reflect the strong and colorful flashes of light, which gemologists call the fire. And finally, gems are precious, and so are you, especially to the people in this room. Your family, friends, and teachers have been here for you and will continue to be your bedrock, your foundation. Have you said thank you? Come back to them for advice often and believe them when they say you've got a special hidden talent. They will provide you with the direction and encouragement to find each new success. So here you are today, looking like $1 million. I know you're ready for the tumbler ahead, ready to pursue your talents, and will stay graciously connected to your community. And we will be here to ooh and ah over your future brilliant endeavors. Congratulations, class, on your accomplishments here at Deerfield School. I am truly proud of you. I wish you much success, and I hope that you will come back to share your adventures with us as you grow and achieve your goals. Congratulations. And now I'd like to ask Dr. Lubarsky, our chief school administrator, if she would come and share a few words.
Good evening, everyone, graduates, parents, family members, guests, members of the Board of Education. I just want to let you know that all the close-ups tonight are brought to you by the Mountainside PTA, so we're very grateful for our new screens, cameras, and projectors. We are here tonight to honor the graduates. But before I get to the heart of my speech, at the risk of sounding like an old grandmother, I would like to talk about how things were a little different when I was your age. But then again, I am an old grandmother, so I guess it's okay if I speak like one. Back in the day when I was in eighth grade, there were only three or four main channels on television and two or three main radio stations. There were probably more newspapers and magazines than there are today, but they were all made of paper. You had to buy them or have them delivered. Most significantly, though, there was no internet. Your viewing choices were simple. In our house, we only had one television. So we all had to agree on one show at a time, and we had to tune into the television at exactly the specific time it was on in order to watch. So soap operas were in the afternoon, my mother's choice. The news was always between 6 and 7, my father's choice. Comedies and dramas were at night. This was always a debate. If you missed your show, there was no podcasting or on demand. You lost your chance. It was really an easy way for my parents to punish us if we did something wrong, because you could never get your show back unless you were lucky enough to catch it in reruns. In terms of the content, for the most part, you knew exactly what you were getting. It was easy to tell the difference between what was fake, Star Trek, and what was real, Walter Cronkite, what was silly, Mork and Mindy, and what was serious, 60 Minutes. Today, however, you are bombarded with so many voices and opinions, literally 24/7. And what is frustrating is that many of these opinions are cleverly disguised as facts. And the shows that are labeled reality really seem to be the furthest from the truth. This past year in particular, we have all been inundated with very strong, determined voices from the presidential candidates, each trying to persuade us with powerful arguments that he or she would be the best leader for our country. And just this past week, we heard some very sad voices as so many Americans try to recover from the loss of loved ones from a terrible tragedy. And these are just two examples. With so much information coming at you from so many different places and in so many different forms, you would think it would be easier to make good choices, but it is really just the opposite. And in addition, believe it or not, it is not only the information we are overloaded with, but it is the actual devices we turn on that prevent us from reflecting clearly and trying to decide what we believe. Just last week in the New York Times, in an article by writer Teddy Wayne entitled The End of Reflection, he described a study which explains that the average person consults a cell phone at least 85 times a day, including phone calls and listening to music. So if you are awake for 16 hours, turning on or checking your phone 85 times means you're doing so about once every 11 minutes, and that doesn't account for internet use on a computer or watching a regular television set, if anyone still does that. This averages to a little more than 5 hours, or over 30% of the time you are awake. This type of activity is so distracting, according to researchers, that it actually reduces your ability and the amount of time you need to reflect and think critically about the world in order to discover what you really think and care about and why. So how can young people like you navigate the information overload in today's society so that you can make good choices? One important way is to take the time to develop your own intelligent, thoughtful voice. Discover what you believe in, so when you hear all of the dissenting voices, you are better equipped to know what direction you should head in and whom you should believe. Of course, this is easier said than done. But the good news is you have had plenty of practice here at Deerfield School. For example, this year alone, in Mr. Young's social studies class, you were asked to consider the possible merits and problems associated with compulsory voting and determine through a researched and well-documented essay whether or not such a system would be in the best interests of our country. Mrs. Owner's Language Arts class, in Mrs. Owner's Language Arts class, you wrote position papers defending your stance on violence in video games. You had to support your position with relevant evidence and analysis from recent articles. You then turned these papers into stirring speeches as you attempted to sway your peers to support your viewpoint. In Mrs. Lavery's science class, you had to collect and use data to support the concept of kinetic molecular theory. Just in case the audience doesn't remember this concept, this is the theory that molecules are always in motion, but as temperature and pressure change, the motion of the molecules changes, which leads to a change in state. Remember? In Mr. Scholl's math class, you related cell phone company plans to linear equations. You were challenged to choose the cell phone plan using different linear equations that you believe was the best deal and support your response with specific data. I am sure your parents would love to hear about the results of this one. And finally, in Mrs. Benty's life skills class, you had 43 minutes to work as a team to make fried rice. This meant that you had to measure, mix, cook, set the table, serve, clean up, and submit a manager's report. This project taught you time management, cooperation, goal setting, and how to delegate, all traits that many companies list first when they describe skills they want in applicants. Already here at Deerfield, we have had students who've sprung into action on their own, expressed their voices strongly, and made significant lasting changes to their world. Last year, a group of eighth graders came to several board meetings armed with data and research, including student surveys, to voice their very persuasive opinion about changing the mascot at Deerfield School. As a result of their strong voices, the mascot was changed to the Huskies, and they have established a legacy that will live on. This year, at next week's board meeting, mind you, school is over tomorrow, another group of eighth graders are preparing a presentation to the board about the need for solar panels in the schools. And I have a sneaking suspicion that their voices will be equally convincing and persuasive. So I am glad to see that so many of you already understand the importance of a strong voice. But now you are getting ready to attend high school. You will have many more opportunities to support and strengthen your voice so you can make intelligent, informed choices as you move forward on the path to adulthood. We have all heard your voices sing in harmony the beautiful rendition of I Lived. We are counting on you to continue to make your voices heard to help us foster a more peaceful and harmonious world. Thank you, congratulations, and I wish you the best of luck.
Thank you. And before we award the diplomas, I'd like to ask Mr. Ruban, who is president of the Mountainside Board of Education, to come up and share some thoughts.
Thank you, Madam Principal. Here I am, once again, staring at the blank page before me, trying to find the right words to say to a group of amazing kids I have seen go from the field in front of the Beechwood cafeteria, to the halls of Deerfield, to the steps of the Capitol, to the streets and neighborhoods of New York City. My heart beats fast, colors and promises, feeling lost, but now and then reaching for something in the distance. Drench yourself in words unspoken. I'll start at the very beginning, a very good place to start. I breathe it in to let it go. Let's roll. When I first saw you from across the room, I could tell that I've loved you for 1,000 years. I'll love you for 1,000 more, unconditionally. Time stands still. Sometimes the smallest things take up the most room in your heart. Well, it's a big, wide world. Get ready to explore. There's so much to find, little Einstein. Live life, breathe air, look around every corner, a discovery. Because when we use our mind, take a step at a time, we can do anything that we want to do. What time is it? Summertime. There's 104 days of summer vacation till school comes along just to end it. It's time to see the brighter side of every situation, building a rocket or fighting a mummy. Because you know that if you live in your imagination, tomorrow you'll be everybody's fascination, soaring, flying, breaking free to infinity and beyond. I ask myself, what am I doing here? First things first, I'm the realist. Drop this and let the whole world feel it. It takes a great deal of courage to stand up to your enemies, but a great deal more to stand up to your friends. A few times I've been around that track, so it's not just gonna happen like that. It's our choices that show what we truly are far more than our abilities. I really wanna know, what do you mean? Just because you find that life's not fair, it doesn't mean that you just have to grin and bear it. Cause the player's gonna play, 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 and the hater's gonna hate, hate, hate. Just let it be. If you've got thick skin and an elastic heart, shake it off. It ain't how hard you hit, it's how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. There's no certainty, only opportunity. Even the smallest person can change the course of the future, like a small boat on the ocean, sending big waves into motion. So long live the pioneers, rebels, and mutineers. Go forth and have no fear. The people who are crazy enough to think they can change the world are the ones who do. So say Geronimo. You may be thinking, are we out of the woods? Are we in the clear yet? Just get ready for work, 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 work. Because success is 1% inspiration, 98% perspiration, and 2% attention to detail. You will find there's always going to be another mountain. You're always going to want to make it move. It's time to try defying gravity. Always going to be an uphill battle, trying to catch the beat, make up your heart. Go and make your luck with the life you choose and say what you need to say in defense of your dreams. And I hope that you don't suffer, but take the pain, because there's going to be a day when you're standing in the Hall of Fame. You are the kings and queens of promise. You look like a movie. You sound like a song. You're like slicker than the guy with the thing on his eye. And really, what's wrong with being confident? Let your freak flag wave, let your freak flag fly. You just gotta ignite the light and let it shine in screaming color. All the things that make us special are the things that make us strong. How can we not talk about family when family's all we got? On behalf of all of those here for you tonight, I'm only one call away, so call me maybe. Let the light guide your way. Hold every memory as you go, and every road you take will always lead you home. I stand before you in awe of all that you achieve, of your limitless potential, your love of life, and the amazing future that awaits. And love, if your wings are broken, please take mine so yours can open too, because it will always be my promise to support you, assist you, lift you up, love you, and believe in your wildest dreams. Lastly, on behalf of your Mountainside Board of Education, with a small assist from 30 Seconds to Mars, Adele, Alessia Cara, Big Time Rush, Bruno Mars, Christina Perry, Charlie Puth, Demi Lovato, Eric Roth, Iggy Azalea, Gwen Stefani, Justin Bieber, John Mayer, J.R.R. Tolkien, Katy Perry, Nicki Minaj, Miley Cyrus, Natasha Bedingfield, One Direction, One Republic, Rachel Platten, Rihanna, Sia, Shepherd, Steve Jobs, Sylvester Stallone, Sinatra, Taylor Swift, The Script, Todd Beamer, ex-ambassadors and the creators of Blue's Clues, Phineas and Ferb, Gladiator, High School Musical, Harry Potter, Hunger Games, iCarly, Little Einstein's Matilda, Modern Family, Peeping a Big Wide World, Winnie the Pooh, Shrek, The Sound of Music, Toy Story, Victorious and Wicked. May the odds be ever in your favor. May your high school years go smoother than a fresh jar of Skippy. And always remember, if you can make it here, you can make it anywhere. Thank you.
Okay, at this time I would like to invite Dr. Lubarsky and our Board of Education members, Mr. Ruban, Mr. Minks, Mr. Joya, Mrs. Jakasitz, Mrs. Motz, Mrs. Parker, Mr. Venice, to join us on stage to award the diplomas. Deerfield Class of 2016, I will ask the first row to rise and please come forward when you are called to receive your diploma. Congratulations this evening to Sarah Mason, Natalia Aos, Isabella Ng, Ryan Duswalt, Alexander Ramey, Alex Becky, Francis Tawa, Victoria Becky, Adrian Monahan, Jack Younghans, Adam Wu, Mia Hughes, Emily Matt Patterson, Alexander Moriak, Riley Ford, Allie Schwartz. Down, Will. Congratulations, William Broda, Megan Light, Olivia DiNorcio, Mia Pino, Jordan Franco, Ariel Noguera, Paige Phillips, Olivia Sodasanti, Caitlin Kolendensky, Jeremy Malave, Anna Freer, Kara Jerzak, Joshua Bezerra, Victoria Wojcik, Thomas Disco, Zoe Andre, Hope Gillen, Hugh McCabe, and congratulations to Joseph Antonucci, Shelby Sankarik, Alana Moriak, Luke Williams, Alex Pupo, Daniel Quinn, Raymond Lee, Lauren Montiero, Elizabeth Fiamingo, Sabrina Ruban, Olivia Chichimara, Jessica Aponte, Abigail Lamera, Matthew Cisneros, Catherine Lawrence, Michelle DeRose, Nicholas Ballman, Zachary Zacharaha, Jane Mervis, John Silva, congratulations to J.J. Post, Robert Clapsey, Kelly Sun, Gia Circelli, Jill Zimmerman. Dean Safey. Allison Zimmerman. Melanie Weaver. Lucas Brzezinski. Domenico DeLuca. Carson Stapleton. John Perrell. Jessica Patathil. Kate Cole. Max Bakalitz. Emmy Wilson. Alyssa Liu. John Giftopoulos. Patrick Murphy. Ava Messler. Congratulations to Erica Dahl, Robert Wargoski, Alexander Felito, Joseph Fabio, Michael Dominguez, Michael Bittner, Jillian Meltzer, Jessica Rowland, Christopher Povell, Ferdinando Mello, Jared Abram, Justin Conklin, James Shields, Claire Hannon, Faith Scott, Alexander Janiak, Alexander DeZagon, Katie Filiacci, Nicholas Manna, Emily Burko, John Hamway, Class of 2016, please stand. Thank you. Class, please be seated. You have completed the educational program in the Mountainside School District. At this time, I would like to invite Mr. Robert Nixon, principal of Governor Livingston High School, to come and receive our class. Mr. Nixon.
Good evening. As the principal of Governor Livingston High School, I would first like to congratulate the eighth grade students of Mountainside on all that you have accomplished. You've made your parents and teachers very proud. I would also like to welcome the class of 2020 to Highlander Country. Governor Livingston is a great school with many diverse offerings that will inspire and encourage you to be the best that you can be. With that in mind, we look forward to seeing you up on the hill in September. Have a safe and enjoyable summer.
Thank you, Mr. Nixon. And now the awards portion of our program. Students, we request that you stand when your name is called so that you may be recognized. You will receive your award immediately after the ceremony, along with your diploma. And now I'd like to invite our first presenter, the Honorable Mayor Paul Mirabelli, who will present three awards on behalf of the Mayor and Council, Borough of Mountainside, the Mountainside Rotary Club, and the Republican Club. Mayor?
Good evening, everyone. On behalf of myself and the council and the whole community, I want to congratulate the 2016 graduating class. I also would like to commend their parents, their family, their friends, their teachers, and the school administration on helping them get a new title tonight, and that would be a graduate. It's very important that we recognize these academic achievements, because by recognizing these academic achievements, we encourage these great kids to do great things. And when they do great things, it's fantastic for the community, and that's what I'm looking for. So congratulations. Tonight, I'm going to be giving out the Co-Salutatorium Awards. They will earn a proclamation and a $200 gift card. And the co-salutatoriums are Kelly X. Sun and Alyssa D. Liu. We're also going to give a proclamation and a $300 gift card to the valedictorian Emily K. Burkow. I'm also here tonight to present the Alan Augustine Good Citizenship Award. Alan Augustine was a longtime New Jersey assemblyman who led his life with the motto, service above self. It's presented annually by the Mountainside Republicans to a boy and girl who best exemplify the values of good citizen that Alan Augustine always demonstrated: honor, honesty, integrity, loyalty, and character. The two students are this year's honoree are Domenico DeLuca and Faye Scott. Congratulations on a well-deserved award.
Thank you. And I'd like to invite Mrs. Sinisi from the Mountainside Rotary Club to come present the Rotary Service Award.
Good evening. I am presenting the Service Award. I personally want to say that we're very impressed with your class and the Rotary Club, because we visit you throughout the years. And each year we present this Rotary Club Service Award to two outstanding students. And it's been a tradition of ours for several years. At least I've been with the Rotary about 15 years. And in memory of Elmer and Emily Hofarth, the service award consists of a certificate that you'll get later on and a check for $200 apiece. So on behalf of the Mountainside Rotary Club, I'd like to congratulate you, and along with everybody else, the graduating class, their parents and teachers. This year goes to a boy and a girl, Joey Antonucci and Allie Schwartz. So congratulations.
Thank you. And Ms. Skolbeck, please come forward and for the Tricia DeRosa World Language Award.
Good evening. My name is Jacqueline Goldbeck, and I was fortunate enough to receive the Tricia DeRosa World Language Award, previously known as the French Award, 4 years ago. Tricia DeRosa loved to travel, meet new people, and pursue foreign language. This award honors a student who shares and excels in these characteristics as well. Learning a foreign language is a task that has never come easy for me. However, winning this award motivated me to persevere through the difficulty and continue my studies of the French language and culture. for the last 4 years at GL. It is with pleasure and honor that I present this year's Language Award to Emily Patterson.
And I will ask Mr. Young to please come present the History Award on behalf of the MEA.
Thank you, but before I get to this year's MEA History Award, I want to recognize the participants from Deerfield's eighth grade class at the annual Relay for Life event. For those of you who are not familiar with it, Relay for Life is an organization team fundraising event for the American Cancer Society to benefit cancer research, treatment, and care for those whose lives have been impacted by cancer. Patients, survivors, caregivers, family members, and friends. This year, I am proud to announce that a total of 5 eighth grade teams of Deerfield students participated with student, adult, and corporate groups from Berkeley Heights, Mountainside, Summit, and New Providence. These 5 Deerfield teams consisted of 47 eighth grade students and raised a total of $20,540. Tonight's available time allows me to only recognize the team leaders, Ali Schwartz, Alex Felito, Domenico DeLuca, Michael Bittner, Sabrina Ruban, and Melanie Weaver. To all Deerfield Relay for Life participants on the stage tonight, I applaud you all for continuing the tradition of Deerfield commitment to this most worthy cause. And as the son of a recent cancer survivor, I thank you. Now, this year's graduating class clarified and disproved several myths about American history and government. For example, there are indeed 100 senators currently serving the United States Senate. If the question would have been about competent senators, the number would be much lower and closer to the one that students have suggested throughout the year. Alaska has been kicked out of the Union. Too many reality shows, I guess. And finally, Abraham Lincoln was assassinated at a movie theater in 1865. A full 40 years before the Nickelodeon. For those of you keeping track at home, ladies and gentlemen, that was the country's first public movie theater, which opened in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Okay. As our year concludes tonight, I hope I have left you and helped you to understand the importance of active citizenship. Government was created by the people to serve and protect the rights of the people. It is the responsibility of all of us to make sure this happens. I urge all of you not only to vote when it is your time, but to pay attention to the issues of the day and be aware of decisions and policies of your elected officials. With our many cherished rights comes much responsibility. Make sure your voice and your vote, when it comes your time, is heard. I have no doubt that this year's recipient of the MEA History Award will take this responsibility to heart. In addition to being an accomplished student, he continues to impress me with his knowledge of politics, government, and current events with a complexity and detail far beyond his years. It is with great pleasure and pride that I award the 2016 MEA History Award to Jack Younghans.
And I invite Mrs. Hemmings to come and award the Leadership Award on behalf of the MEA.
Good evening y buenas noches a todos. First, I'd like to give my enhorabuena to all of my Spanish students. I've had all of them over the years, and especially this year. But I'm up here tonight to offer the MEA Leadership Award to one of these students who has always stepped up to the plate. When something needs to be done around Deerfield, he's there. and he rounds up the troops, whatever he needs to get the job done. This person has been a great help to me this year, and I've watched him help other teachers, other students, the staff of the school. He is truly a leader. I would like to award MEA's Leadership Award to Domenico DeLuca.
Thank you. I'd like to invite Mrs. Aponte to award four awards on behalf of the Mountainside PTA as well as the MEF.
Good evening. Before I begin, I want to congratulate all the graduates and their families. I wish you all success in your future endeavors. Each year, the PTA grants two scholarships. First to a student who demonstrates creativity in writing, and second to a student for creativity in art. These scholarships are recommended by the language arts teacher, Ms. Honor, and the art teacher, Ms. Slotkin. This year, I'm pleased to announce that the PTA has added a third scholarship to a student for special achievement. This scholarship is recommended from the whole eighth grade team. This year's nominee for the PTA Creativity and Writing Scholarship goes to a student who has shown interest and improvement through the school year in language arts. In particular, this student has shown great strength during our study of poetry. Not only has this student produced creative and innovative narrative works, but has excelled in literacy and poetic analysis. Over the course of the year, this student has proved to be well-deserving of this award and will continue to exhibit outstanding creativity in high school. This year's scholarship for creativity in writing goes to Olivia DiNorcio. I have three more. Imagination, originality, and individuality define the word creativity. This student selected for the PTA Creativity in Art Award embodies these traits perfectly. Her talent in art carry over to her musical abilities and her outstanding literacy skills. On behalf of the Mountainside PTA, I am pleased to present this award to Kate Cole. Lastly, for our Special Achievement Scholarship. This student was selected to receive the Achievement Award based on her achieved success throughout her middle school years, due to her dedication, preparedness, responsibility, and organization. This student continually advocates for herself, and these skills will continue to support her as she continues on her educational journey. The PTA Special Achievement Award goes to Alana Moriak. Okay, I'm putting on my MEF hat now. Wendy Cacamo couldn't be here tonight, so I'm presenting on behalf of her. Each year, the MEF awards a scholarship to students who exemplify outstanding character. This year, I am pleased to present three awards of $250. The first award goes to a nominee who received nine nominations. On behalf of the MEF, I'd like to give this award to Domenico DeLuca. The second and third awards go to two individuals who also received several nominations attesting to their character and impressive community service. I am proud to present these awards to Jill Zimmerman and Allie Zimmerman. Congratulations on behalf of PTA and MEF.
Thank you. I'd like to invite Ms. Honor to come up and share the Rotstock Writing Award.
Every year, the Rotstock family generously awards three talented eighth graders at Deerfield School with first, second, and third place writing awards. Students were to creatively respond to a choice of writing prompts, exhibiting their individual strengths as writers. This year, it was extremely difficult for the panel to select just three submissions, as there were an overwhelming amount of outstanding essays. Students composed original and innovative writing pieces tackling subjects such as the Vietnam War, bullying, medical disabilities, and gang violence. I am extremely impressed and proud of the work produced from our students for this award, and this opportunity really highlighted how the students have grown as writers over the year. I am so proud of these students and confident that they will continue to shine and develop their skills throughout high school. Each student that placed in this contest is hardworking, bright, and highly deserving. Although there are only three placements in this contest, we wanted to note an honorable mention to a specific narrative piece that we thought was extremely powerful. For his submission to the Rostock Writing Contest, we would like to award an honorable mention to Lucas Rosinski. The third place for the Rostock Writing Contest, Jessica Rowland. Second place, Jill Zimmerman. And first place, Ariel Noguera.
Yes. And now the Beverly Ellenport Memorial Award.
Each year, we award the Beverly Ellenport Reading Award to two deserving eighth grade students. Both of these students are avid readers who enjoy reading, discussing literature, and are always looking for the next great read. I would like to present the Beverly Ellenport Reading Award to Riley Ford and Isabella Ng.
Thank you, Ms. Lenore. Mr. Rosenblum will come and present two awards. First, the Jean Wilhelms Vocal Music Award, and then secondly, the Drama Award.
All right, thank you very much. First, I need to thank the entire class. When I ask 95 kids to sing, I never know what's gonna happen. So I couldn't be more proud of the job they did tonight. So guys, thank you so much. I consider myself to be so blessed to have had the opportunity to teach 25 amazing boys and girls an eighth grade chorus this year. Any one of them could be called up here to win the chorus award tonight. They each have traits that are unique and special, and they will all be missed very much. Tonight I've been asked to present awards to two of my chorus members. While the first person that I'm presenting an award to has an amazing voice and is extremely talented, that is not why I decided she should win this first award. I chose a student because she is truly a great person, a role model for all of the other students to follow. She's extremely dedicated, hardworking, and caring. So dedicated that I don't think she's missed a day of school or chorus this year. I know that the student will grow up to be a fantastic leader and will continue to be an example in high school that all other students should follow. I'd like to ask Ariel Noguera to please stand and accept this award. The second award, this next chorus award will go to a student that has been by my side since my first day. Whether it was in school chorus, select choir, the musical, or just hanging out in my room, I will cherish every second that I got to spend with him. Some people are just born to sing, and he definitely is one of them. It has been my pleasure to see him develop from a T-bird in Greece to an outstanding donkey in Shrek. In our 3 years together, his voice and confidence have grown and developed significantly, and I cannot wait to see what the future holds for this outstanding young man. Josh Bezerra, please accept this award from me.
Thank you, Mr. Rosenblum. Was that not the drama award?
That was two chorus awards.
That was two chorus awards. We're going to have also a drama award.
All right, thank you. If you've seen the shows the past few years, then you could probably figure out who this award is going to. But before I call her up, I have a few words that I'd like to say about the student. She is what we call in the theater business a triple threat. She's an outstanding singer, dancer, actor, as well as the most dedicated student that I could have ever dreamed of. It will seem so strange not having her at play rehearsals next year and not hearing her voice soar above the others and not seeing her smile stand out in the crowd. She was the most amazing and perfect Dorothy that I could have ever asked for. So Erica Dahl, please stand up and accept this award. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Rosenblum. I'll ask our Mr. Wise, also a member of our music department, to please come forward and give our Band Excellence Award.
This year's eighth grade band class has been a joy to teach. It's a group filled with memorable personalities and huge amounts of talent. We work together for 3 days a week, solving musical problems, kind of like scientists in a lab, except with music. And we have a pretty good time doing so, or at least I think so. So choosing one person for the Band Excellence Award has been a really remarkably difficult task. You're all just so driven and so interested and so good-hearted. And I just know that if you keep those qualities and take them to high school, you're really going to do great things. So thank you for making my job really awesome. The students in the eighth grade band have come really far over our 3 years together, but the recipient of this year's Band Excellence Award has arguably come the farthest, since prior to sixth grade, he had never played a musical instrument before. Since then, he has not only learned the necessary skills, but he has excelled to the point where students throughout the band, grades 6 through 8, look to him as a role model and as a leader. He is always helpful, always kind, and always patient with students, no matter what age they are. Plus, he's a fine musician with eagerness to learn and master new ideas. But there's one memory that I'll take with me of this student. One afternoon last year, he stayed after school to work with me on one of the more challenging songs we were playing at the time. And he told me he was having trouble with these two specific measures. It was about 3 seconds worth of music. And we went over the rhythm together a couple times just to make sure he had the feel of it. And I told him I'd come back in a couple minutes and check it out. And I went off to work with a few other students, but it was a busy day, and those couple minutes turned into 20 minutes. So I walked back into the room, expecting to see him, you know, checked out. And what's he doing? He's practicing those same two measures of music, and he's been doing it for the last 20 minutes. And it's just a testament to his dedication. And it's just so proud to see that kind of thing. He didn't practice it till he got it right. He practiced it till he couldn't get it wrong. So this year's band recipient shows drive, dedication, and he does it all with a smile on his face. Among the members of the band who recognize all these qualities, there's a growing grassroots movement. It's called hashtag RobbieForPrez2016. Given the current state of affairs, I'd seriously consider voting for him. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to present this year's Band Excellence Award to Robert Wargaski.
Thank you, Mr. Wise. I'd like to invite from the PBA, Officer Parada, to come and share the Mathematics and Science Awards.
On behalf of the PBA Local 126, I want to congratulate this class again. Great job, guys. I had a long speech planned out, but Mr. Ruban stole my thunder, so. The two awards are, one is for math, one is for science. PBA Local 126 would like to give the math award to Alyssa Liu. And the Science Award goes to Emily Burkow. Congratulations again.
Thank you, Officer Parada. And for Excellence in Fine Art from the MEA, Mrs. Slotkin.
Parents, Board of Education, Dr. Labarsky, Mrs. Richards, and class of 2016. I remember most of you as wide-eyed third graders. You were so excited to be in art, Well, the 6 years have flown by, and those cute third graders are replaced with beautiful and handsome young people going into high school. Solar system necklaces and self-portraits have blossomed into the wonderful eighth grade wall. This will be my last opportunity to address you as a group, and I'd like to wish you all the very best. Use all of your talents, your brains and hands and hearts and voices to create a masterpiece that is your life. I will miss you all, and I am so happy that I am graduating with you. Woo! The Mountainside Education Association, which is made up of your teachers, paraprofessionals, and support staff, allows me to give a fine arts award. This is given to a student who excels not only in visual arts, but in commitment, creativity, and individuality. This student is an enigma because she is right-brained and left-brained, and I wanted to bring a picture in because she paints in a most unusual way. The last time I saw her painting on the wall, she had about 7 paintbrushes, each one sticking out of her finger, kind of like Edward Scissorhands, and it was fantastic. This year, the award goes to Emily Burko.
Thank you, Mrs. Slotkin. And from the Mountainside Historic Preservation, I'd ask Mr. Daniels to come up and award the Arthur J. Brahm Award.
Good evening, everyone. It was 50 years ago tonight I was on that stage, so there is life after Deerfield School. This year marks the 16th anniversary of the Arthur J. Brahm Mountainside Historic Preservation Award. It's a scholarship award in the amount of $200. It's given each year to a graduating eighth grade student who's the winner of an essay contest on a facet of Mountainside's history. This year's award for her essay explaining pride in the history of Mountainside goes to Emily Burko. Congratulations, Emily.
Thank you, Mr. Daniels. I'd like to ask Mrs. Chichimara to come to the podium to award the PAL Scholarship Award.
Each year, the Mountainside PAL gives a certificate of $500, a $500 scholarship to a graduating eighth grader based upon them being a Mountainside resident, having a GPA of 3.0 or better, participating in extracurricular activities, and the hardest part, writing an essay on volunteerism and the importance on the community. This year, we had received numerous entries with students discussing activities and the importance of leadership. However, one stood out talking about doing something good for the community, helping their community immeasurably. She stated, helping one another out by volunteering is what a community is. And we heard from her tonight when she said thank you to all the volunteers for the eighth grade activities in her valedictorian speech. Congratulations to Emily Burko.
And I'd like to ask Ms. Goldstein to please come and award the Ryan Faiella Memorial Award.
Each year since 2001, the Ryan Faiella Foundation has awarded a scholarship to a graduating Deerfield student to assist them in their future academic pursuits. The scholarship is in memory of Ryan Faiella, a former Deerfield student who passed away at the age of 13 back in 2000. The criteria utilized to make this selection include scholastic accomplishment, athletic achievement, and community service. Many previous scholarship winners have gone on to make significant accomplishments in the fields of medicine, business, and education. As an example, the assistant principal of Governor Livingston High School, Mark Cantagallo, is a previous award winner. They have also volunteered their time and talents in the Mountainside and Berkeley Heights communities, as well as places like Appalachia and Mexico. The Ryan Fiella Foundation is pleased to award a scholarship in the amount of $500 to Robert Wargaski. They would also like to extend their congratulations to the graduating Deerfield class of 2016 and wish them all the best in their future endeavors. Thank you.
And it is my pleasure to award the Presidential Excellence Award winners. Students, I'm going to ask that you, when I call your name, you stand and remain standing. These are the students who have achieved a cumulative GPA of an A- or above through all of 6th, 7th, and 8th grade. Jared Abram. Zoe Andre. Victoria Becky. Emily Burko. Joshua Bezerra. Matthew Cisneros. Kate Cole. Michelle DeRose, Alexander DeZagon, Erica Dahl, Ryan Duswall, Alexander Felito, Elizabeth Fiamingo, Riley Ford, John Hamway, Claire Hannon, Alexander Janiak, Kara Jerzak, Catherine Lawrence, Megan Leik, Raymond Lee, Alyssa Liu, Jeremy Malave, Nicholas Manna, Sarah Mason, Ava Messler, Adrian Monahan, Lauren Montero, Alana Moriak, Alexander Moriak, Isabella Ng, Ariel Noguera, John Perel, Jessica Patathil, Emily Patterson, Jay Post, Alex Pupo, Alexander Ramey, Jessica Rowland, Sabrina Ruban, Dean Safey, Kelly Sun, Robert Wargaski, Melanie Weaver, Luke Williams, Adam Wu, Jack Younghands, Zachary Zacharaha, Allison Zimmerman, and Jillian Zimmerman. A hard-working class. Thank you. You may be seated. This award recognizes those who have maintained this average for 3 years. They've shown great effort in their academics, and they will receive a certificate signed by the U.S. Secretary of Education. Thank you. Well done. And now I just want to take a minute to thank all of you presenters for taking time, for being committed to our school, to our children, to our community. It means a lot for you to be here, and it means a lot for you to award these awards to our students. And so I thank you for your time and effort to all of our community groups. At this time, I would like to invite our class co-salutatorians, Alyssa Liu and Kelly Sun, to present the farewell address.
My name is Kelly Sun.
And my name is Alyssa Liu.
And we are honored to be the co-salutatorians of the graduating class of 2016. This is both a greeting and farewell to our Deerfield memories, as well as a look into the future. These are our last moments as Deerfield students, since the day we first walked through these doors into a foreign and gigantic world. Little did we know, it would soon forever become a treasured place in our hearts and seem almost like a second home to us eighth graders. We would like to thank all of the administrators, faculty, teachers, and parents once more for accomplishing the seemingly impossible task of preparing us for high school and ensuring our experience at the school was so enjoyable and memorable. To the old friends and familiar faces of our grade, Remember imagining this very moment from our third grade selves, thinking it would never come? Well, now we're here and have already been handed our diplomas, gradually moving away from our loving memories of Deerfield School and inching toward our bright high school careers of next September. Despite the continual changes that our school has gone through while we were students here, including the major evolution of the school mascot, as the saying goes, the more things change, the more they stay the same. The only thing these changes do is strengthen the bonds formed between the eighth grade class during our journey together from kindergarten through the last hours with our beloved Deerfield.
This is also a look into the future of each and every one of us eighth graders. Our trip to New York City to see the play Matilda taught us through the miraculous tale of a little girl that no matter how small or insignificant we may seem, everyone has the power to change their story. Matilda sang, "Just because you find that life's not fair, it doesn't mean you just have to grin and bear it." Never forget that together, we can cause change in our communities and make things right. In high school, we will not only be righteous and courageous heroes, but we will also be scientists, experimenting with the new and discovering what the future holds. The time ahead is our chance to show the world what we are made of by balancing our academics and extracurriculars during this period of self-discovery. Of course, our journey does not end there. Beyond lies foggy and mysterious, yet beautiful futures for all of us, illuminated by the light within ourselves. We know that everybody is both anxious and excited for the coming years. They are filled with adventure, risks, and new opportunities. Thank you to all those who gave their time and effort to enhance our experience here as students in our precious school. We will always be grateful for your kindness and nurture through these formative years of our lives. And finally, to our fellow classmates, though we may be separated by time and distance apart, we will always cherish these wonderful years and forever remain the Deerfield graduating class of 2016.
Congratulations to everyone for reaching this milestone.
Thank you, Alyssa and Kelly. I'd like to take a moment to recognize several retiring staff members. The following staff members, Mrs. Kathleen McDonald, who's here, give a wave. Mrs. Anne-Marie Pyrus, Mrs. Judith Siegel, Mrs. Claire Sennett, and Mrs. Lynn Slotkin. Together, these staff members have dedicated many years of their lives to serving the children of Mountainside. We are indebted to them for the lessons, the extra tutoring, the incredible artwork, the cheering from the sidelines, and their true caring spirits. Their work here will be remembered and appreciated for many years to come. We all thank you, and we wish you much happiness in your future endeavors. Congratulations. As we conclude, I'd like to extend our gratitude to the Board of Education members and Dr. Lebarski for their constant encouragement and support of our children. We cannot complete this ceremony without also thanking those who work behind the scenes, our guidance counselor, Ms. Goldstein, our eighth grade teachers, Mr. Rosenblum, Mrs. Barone, Mr. DeVico, and his custodial crew. Thank you. And finally, I'd like to give a heartfelt thank you to the eighth grade parents and families for your support, hard work, and dedication to each of our students throughout the school year. Graduates, after the close of the ceremony, we ask that you proceed to the cafeteria to receive your diplomas from your teachers. Award winners should meet the award sponsors in the media center to receive your award and diploma and take a photo. Refreshments are available in the media center lobby just outside our back right door here for families and friends. Thank you for coming tonight, and I wish you a happy summer.